Hi, everybody. It's Maria Burke here with another 3-2-1 Focus Together interview. And my guest today is Olive McDonough. Olive, would you like to introduce yourself, please? You are so welcome.
Thank you so much for having me. Hi, everyone. Olive McDonough from butterflycottageretreat.ie. So another from the heart of Ireland, like your good self. And yeah, I run Relax and Nourish retreats here. So I have a small little retreat center where I run all things relaxing and nourishing. So lots of juicy life. So nature, life force foods, sound healing, yoga, meditation, all things to relax and for people who want to really take some time out of the crazy busy world that it is. But not at the moment, as you might imagine. So I am retreating myself at the moment and yeah, working on some other stuff, but spending lots of time in the garden and yeah, enjoying what is, making the most of our time at home now. So yeah, so thanks for having me.
Yeah, well, it's great to have you here. And I think that's a very valid point. I think for all of us right now is we need to retreat for ourselves and take the time because we've been given, it's like the whole world is on pause and we've been given this wonderful opportunity. And especially for those of us who kind of work in the area, to actually, you know, physician heal thyself, to actually do for ourselves what we're always doing for everybody else. Because I know myself, like last week, I hit a wall of exhaustion and I just completely pulled back now. And I'm so glad I have, but it's so easy, you know, to be helping everybody else and to be not to be helping ourselves.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So what I'd love to do though, Olive, with you is I know you've had a very interesting journey into your current life. From a very different life. And I know there are probably a lot of people watching on, and I also have come from the corporate world. And I think there are probably people who are sitting now and they're thinking and they're reflecting and they're wondering, what's going to happen on the end of COVID-19 and can they really go back into that space again? So would you like to share your journey with us and like where you came from and how you got to where you are now? Because like these are the stories, you know, it's like, you don't get a guide to bring you up the Himalayas who hasn't gone the journey. And I think now a lot of people more than ever need the inspirational stories, you know, for not only just for hope, but also for a bit of guidance. So the floor is yours, my dear.
Well, thank you. And I guess part of the name of my retreat, Butterfly Cottage Retreat, so the butterfly, it's all about transformation. And I guess anybody who knows me well or in my life and my family, it was just like dramatic change. So from formerly, I was a chartered accountant, like working a really busy lifestyle. So on the treadmill, I enjoyed my work to some extent, but I really wasn't passionate and I wasn't maybe using all of my gifts. Now, some of the gifts were transferable, as is always the case from different careers, because I worked in training for part of it. But again, I was in an office, I was surrounded by computers. Just the energy for me was not my ideal. I was on the go, go, go. And then even from going working like really long hours, like working hard, partying hard, playing hard. It was just all this manic go, 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 you know, just always doing, 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 getting, 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 having, having, having. And on this weird hamster wheel of life where you're not present. You're just kind of on a hamster wheel going round and round and not even taking the time out to reflect or retreat or wondering, is this where I want to be? Is this the life I want? Am I sharing my gifts? Am I connected to myself? Even where I am, who's surrounding me? You know, what does my day involve? Like all the little pieces of the day, is this what I would choose? It's like, that's what they say about being happy. It's like when your life is, what you have is what you're choosing to have. So I guess, yeah, a big part of the journey was, you know, it happened to me. I guess I became ill, and with this chronic illness that now I have to manage, I had no choice but to reflect. So in hospital with surgeries, and that gave me the time to really reflect on what the life that I want to have. So Yeah, it was like connecting what are my values, which are health and freedom and music and sound and nature, and really just creating the life around what I want here. So yeah, for a journey from, I always say, like a binge drinking, like at the weekends I'd be out partying because I'd work so hard I'd have to like just get out of my mind and out of my reality, and just, yeah, very different life. And now drinking green juices in the countryside and playing harmoniums and, yeah, just really getting into the juice of life, I guess, the music and nature's food. So that they're my what I'm so passionate about, I guess, because they helped me so much. Like, and I guess I'm so inspired about it all. Like even the last phase as a chartered accountant in the office, I had them all doing juice detoxes and like was, you know, into meditation and yoga. So yeah, a very different life now. My family would even say it. They thought I was cracked as a coot, obviously. Here I was, like, I always say my mother thought I was going off selling feathers at the top of a mountain when I said I was changing my home into a retreat and inviting, you know, strangers to come and stay with me and do all this different stuff. They actually thought I'd lost the plot.
Right, right. And I'm having problems here with my video again. I don't think it's going to come back. Anyway, do you know, I'm going to leave the picture up and I'm just going to keep talking to you, right? So was it when you were in hospital that you started trying out these new things, or what exactly, how? Because I know juicing, what you've said to me, like there's two big things, the chanting and the juicing are like your two main focuses, right?
Absolutely, yeah.
Juicing start when you were in hospital, or what was the first thing when you were in hospital or around? So,
after my first surgery. So when I after I was in hospital and had surgeries, I had the time to go, well, basically, I was told by doctors that even though I have a chronic illness, and they said to me and my mother at the time, it was many years ago, that even though I didn't have cancer, I may as well have, and it was just about managing my life. And I guess after that was said to me, I just thought, no way, this is not going to be my life, not a chance. So I was thinking, well, let me see, how might I make it better? And I had heard about, you know, changing to vegetarian food, and I'm not fully anything. I don't label myself as vegan, vegetarian, anything. I have a balanced life, and I, again, through what I've gone through, so many different phases and different learnings and all this stuff to do with food and juicing. But juicing has stayed with me the whole time. And I thought, well, how can I help my health? And I went actually on retreat. I started going to retreats in 2008, and that kind of, it was a vegetarian cookery and relaxation retreat I went to. And it, you know, it opened a whole new world to me. And then I started going on loads of retreats. Then I trained as a nutritionist, trained in raw food juice therapy. And I got on, and then I realized I'd gotten so big into the food, I was making too many attachments to food. And then I realized it's not all food. And then I got into the energy work and trained in Reiki and different, like lots of different tools and the yoga and meditation. But it was the food absolutely is energy, and tapping into the juicing and the life force energy, that it's so digestible and can give our bodies so much life that we get to consume that life in such a digestible way using the juices and the smoothies. And that kind of the nutrition brought me then to more of going inward in myself and connecting to myself with yoga, meditation, and sound healing. And that brought me then Kundalini yoga. And even before that, going to other temples and retreats, that just the music, the sound of different instruments, the bowls, the gong that I play, the harmonium, and just connecting, for me, mantra meditation, which might seem really woo to some people, but it really helped me. I had a passion for music my whole life, and that was like an inner gift that I hadn't really expressed. So the mantra then allowed me to really tune into myself, like our own sacred sound within, tuning into our own vibration. It just took things to a whole new level, just internally, health-wise, and helped to bring me back to life. So, yeah.
That's amazing, because I actually started a yoga course yesterday. With a mantra meditation. I had tried to do primordial sound back in 2004, but like I was just too busy. I couldn't sit still for 5 minutes, let alone 20 minutes. So this morning I did my meditation, and it was so easy, and it was so lovely. And I'm really, it's something I've treated myself to, but I so agree. Like, it's just, you know, and I would do a lot of inner work anyway. So it's just like, like that. It's always like finding the next thing that feels right and then working out and kind of tweaking our tool set that we use for ourselves. Isn't that kind of the way it is?
For sure. And I think as well, for a lot of people who are new to meditation, a brilliant thing with the mantra meditation, and some of the ones I do have movement as well, but not only are you, like for meditation, sitting down and staying still, for a lot of people, it's like going from here to here, and it's just not possible. So when you bring in the movement and the sound, it's just way easier to go from busy, 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 to maybe a little movement and a mat focusing on words as well as the breath, than trying to go from to pure nothingness. So it's just, it's a really great tool to bring you from that busy, busy, busy mind and body to slow down. Like it's like trying to do everything at once instead of doing it in little stages. So it's a great door into, and especially if you love music. Yeah, it's fabulous.
Yeah. So I think as well, though, when you're talking about mantra meditation, you're actually talking about yoga chanting. Is that your kind of mantra meditation? Are you talking about where you've got a mantra that you're repeating as well?
Well, it can be either or. So a mantra, which is mantra, is mind wave or mental projection. And what that is an addition, it's an additional focus. So you can tune in. So some of the mantras, like, for example, the yoga chants in Kundalini yoga, the words are sacred. So they'll have, for example, the tip of the tongue will touch off a meridian in your mouth. A different sound will create a different vibration in the body. So it's internally healing on so many different levels. Or you could choose, I love you. Or like another one I do is the Ho'oponopono. And that's a mantra on my album, actually. And it's a mantra which it's four lines. And it's, I'm sorry, please forgive me, I love you, thank you. So they can be in any language, it can be any words, or it can be a specific sacred chant. So there's many different ways to do it, yeah.
Oh, that's wonderful that you're explaining that to us. Because I remember actually going one evening to, like that, it was yoga, but when I went in, it was chanting. I was going, to me, yoga was something you did on your yoga mat. Do you know the way? And it's like to understand, you know, the way we have a, you know, you get something in your head and it sticks in your head in a particular way and you don't understand the breadth of what it's all about. So that's really, really interesting.
Totally. Well, with yoga, interesting you say that now, because so exactly that, a lot of people think yoga is in gym clothes, wrapping your leg around your shoulder, but yoga, the word yoga means union, and it's a way of becoming into yourself. So the yoga that I teach is Kundalini yoga, and same Radiant Child is the Kundalini for kids. So I do those, not at the moment, obviously, I'm doing online, but generally then the Kundalini yoga, it brings in all the different limbs of yoga. So you have pranayama, which is the breath work. Then you have the kriyas, which are the movement, and that's the physical part, which is like hatha yoga. And then you have basically yoga nidra, which is you're panning out and you're just absorbing in corpse pose. You're just lying there receiving in relaxation. And that's one of my favorites. It's like, if not the most important posture, it's where all the energy you've created through the movements and the breath gets to be absorbed and integrated into your body. So there's a huge misconception that if you're going to do yoga, you need to be flexible, and it's quite the opposite. It's like it's what brings in even mental flexibility and balance. It brings union, just everything comes together. So it's really life-changing, and it's even just having a snippet of it that might encourage you to try something new, because it's remarkable. Like the feedback, it's just opens a whole new world of connecting with yourself. It's fab.
Yeah, and I think like right now it's such an important and such a great opportunity, the time we have now, to try little things and get snippets of little things. Yeah, there's something else you mentioned though a minute ago, and that's your album. Do tell us about your album, because as soon as you mentioned it to me, just as we were getting set up, you just came alive. So all about your album.
I have a love for music. So I sang in church my whole life. And then when Kundalini Yoga opened a whole new door to music, when I realized going on an event that, because I had heard, obviously, doing yoga, you hear it on a CD player or whatever. This was years ago. And then it was like I came across at a mantra weekend, and it was like harmoniums playing, gongs, bowls. And it was like this was a harmonium on this particular weekend. And even at the temple up in the Hare Krishna temple I go to, and yeah, just this music was so, brought me so alive to the point that I bought a harmonium. I'll show you now. It's like a mini organ.
Fabulous.
And I bought in a harmonium for my birthday a few years ago, and I was like, I haven't put it down since. I just love it. So I created, since then, last year, at the end of last year, I launched this Relax and Nourish album. And it was like, what I say, it's like, if you can't come to the retreat, this is like a retreat at home. So the album is two mantra meditations. The first one is from Kundalini Yoga. The first one is a gorgeous mantra meditation, and it's about, it's been known to lift depression. It's just, these are sacred words from ancient, Gurmukhi is the language. So, and often I think when the language of the chants are not our own, you can really bring yourself into the vibration because you're not thinking about the words. I find that can be helpful for some people. And then the second track is like an 11-minute pain release mantra, and it just, oh, it's so gorgeous. I do it with a bowl, and the mantra is about releasing pain. It's called Sunye. It's a deep listening chant. And it's, yeah, it's really nice. And then the third one is the Ho'oponopono. It's a Hawaiian meditation technique, and that's the English one I mentioned earlier. And then finally, there's like a 20-minute, it's 17 or 18 minutes, close to 20 anyway, and it's a guided relaxation where I bring in sound healing to that one. So it's a guided, because often people find it so difficult to relax just themselves that they need to allocate time, which is why we have retreats or even classes or this, like you can just put on the album and it helps you just to really, it's a body scan, a guided relaxation, and then it goes into the gong. So that's where the sound healing, which I trained in, comes into it. It's just remarkable when you learn about the instruments are tuned to these high vibrations and frequencies. So what they do is they help to bring our body in line with the instrument. So it's like if you play two notes and one will resonate off the other on a guitar or even an instrument. So it's like our bodies then are attuned to match the frequency, the higher frequency of the gong, for example, or the bowls or the harmonium. And it just, again, they're just like great ways to help your body to relax. So yeah, that was a really exciting project I had. It was like, you know, bringing all the different pieces that I absolutely love to do at my retreat together onto an album. And then I've another one nearly ready actually, but it's been delayed with what's going on at the moment. And then I launched a kids single as well, which is based on Deepak Chopra's spiritual laws, and it's one we use for our warm-ups in kids yoga all the time. But funny enough, the kids, their favorite part of yoga, when I did a little video with them, and it was relaxation. They love to be guided to relax as well. It's just, yeah, so all things, yeah, relaxing and nourishing albums, and I have another couple of ones coming up. So that's the excitement here at Butterfly Cottage, and thank you for asking.
Yeah, no, because it sounds absolutely fabulous. So if people want to buy your CDs now, are you selling those through your website, through your Facebook page, or is there somewhere else they need to go for them?
Yeah, so I on through my website, butterflycottageretreat.ie, the CDs are there. They're also on iTunes, and people can email olive@butterflycottageretreat.ie and I can send you the links. They're like, there are links online if you want digitally. And then I have hard copies here at my retreat, which I post, and they're at another local venue here as well. So, okay. Yeah.
I'll put all those links anyway below this video for anybody who wants to purchase. So that's wonderful. So do you have any tips that you want to share? Because I want to get you to play your harmonium for us.
Oh, right.
Right, if you will. But have you any tips for us that you want to share? You know, because my voice is going here now because you're clearing a lot for me when I'm listening to you. Because you're actually finding a lot of things that people would like might have been wondering about, you know, people who are new on the journey. But have you any tips you want to share for us, or have you any insights you want to share for us about what's going on?
Sure. Well, as in, to keep it simple, would be the top tip of starting like with a little thing, because often I think life is just overwhelming, the same as being on that treadmill where there's just so much going on all the time. And I guess would be, so not trying to overhaul your life immediately, would be just to do a little bit by little bit. And how that can be, a tip would be to assign yourself maybe 10 minutes a day. Start small. Like, people might try, oh, I'll do 2 hours of this or 4 hours of this or a day at this, and it just doesn't happen. So to start small, and it could be as simple as you allocate yourself 10 minutes, and then within that 10 minutes, you do like 3 minutes of a breathing exercise, or, you know, just to 3 minutes of closing your eyes and just being with yourself. It's just, it's a little tip to the moment. So that would be on the relaxation side. It would be like, you know, think of something that would relax you. And then some days that could be breathing. Another day it might be to do a task that has been on your list forever and driving you crazy that you can't relax because of. So either clear something that's stopping you relaxing, or just take a moment just to even go inwards. And then just to have something to nourish your body as well. So I would say I'm all about relaxing and nourishing. So to take 3 minutes even to relax a day if you can, or 3 days a week, or 1 day a week to start. And then I would suggest just something to nourish you. So something from nature. It could be, you know, a juice. It could be just a fresh piece of fruit. It could be a flower that you smell. It could be hugging a tree. Just something that will actually nourish you to connect with life and yourself and energy, because it can be so energizing as well. So they would be a couple of tips.
Lovely. Sure. Now I have one question that's popping into my head, right? Sure. Which is, if you were to think of that girl who was sitting in her bed sick in hospital, and if you had one piece of advice for that you now looking back, because I'm sure I'm getting shivers all over even asking this, so I'm definitely being guided. There's somebody listening to this who needs this piece of information. What is the one piece of advice you would have for somebody who's really maybe at a scary crossroads, is probably the best way to put it?
Yeah, my advice would be to go through the discomfort and the fear to get to the other side. It's so worth it. And to listen to yourself, not everybody else. So had I just gone with the flow, I'd still be an accountant. I mean, I'm not saying my life was awful, like there were some parts of it that were great, but I certainly wasn't tuned into my gifts of, for example, music. I was in choirs and stuff, but as in, I would just say to that unwell person, just to follow their dream. It's like, you know, we can tune into life or we can tune out of life. I would say tune in. That would be my one thing. Tune in, keep tuning in.
And listen to yourself. Let your own voice, listen to your own voice and hear your voice over what everybody else might think is right for you, I suppose, as well. That's kind of the bit that's coming in to the end of that. Right. Wonderful. Thank you, Olive. Will you play something for me, please, to wrap up?
For sure, I'd only love to. Any excuse to play music and I'm there. Sure. Well, I play you maybe just like a minute and a half of one of the mantras from my album, if you'd like.
Wonderful, yeah. And if you talk us through it and tell us what it is so we have a better understanding. And I would so agree with you, that whole thing of, I know myself, if you're given a word as a mantra, or even when you're singing something in a different language, you're not attached to what the words mean or trying to make sense of them. You just tunes you into a different space, for sure. Yeah. The floor is all yours again, my dear.
Okay. So this is called the Mool Mantra, and it's a part of a Gurmukhi. it sounds funny. So it's an Indian language, and it's a scripture, an ancient scripture from the Sikh tradition, this one. And it's about us being all one creation. So it basically really helps us to tune into ourselves and to overcome. And this is, it's a mood booster. It takes us out of our mind. It's believed to clear fate and elevate those even from depression. So that's the mantra, which is brilliant, obviously. And the mantra words, so it's Ek Onkar Satnam. And it's basically, I play it with harmonium and we basically repeat. So with the mantras is you repeat over and over again. So I'll just do one round of it, maybe two. And you can, just to close your eyes. I'd invite you now even to just to come to a position where your spine is kind of neutral, so the energy can flow, and bring your eyes to a close. And just, again, just bringing awareness to your breath and breathing in, just following your breath on the in-breath, exhaling and breathing out, and just allowing the sounds to just allow you to relax further. And again, anytime you notice thoughts coming in, just to go back to the breath and just to allow the sounds of the harmonium now to enter into your system.
That was absolutely amazing. My whole back is relaxed. I am probably ready for a snooze now. So that was wonderful. Thank you, Olive, so much. Is there anything else you want to share with us before we go?
Thank you. No, not at all. And just to show you that even in that like couple of minutes, it shows you don't need to revamp, or I mean, it's great obviously piecemeal revamping your life or changing things, but even just bringing yourself to that moment with the breath and a bit of sound in 1 minute can literally dramatically shift your nervous system, your mind, just everything. It can be so simple.
Yeah, and
I want to say a huge thank you for having me and allowing me to share my music and my story. Thank you so much.
Thank you for being here. And one other thing that really strikes me as well is, you know, that whole thing of just changing one little thing. Because, you know, they say if a ship leaves the harbor and only changes by 1 degree, which is only, you know, a tiny amount, you know, 6 months out, that ship is in a completely different location than it would have been otherwise. And I so agree with you. If we try to change too much or do too many things at the same time, it just doesn't stick. And it's just one little gentle change at a time, and then the next little gentle change. So thank you so much. I'm so grateful to you, Olive. I know you couldn't see me for most of the time because I don't know what happened with the camera, but I wasn't meant to be seen today. This is for you to be seen, right? So I want to thank everybody for being here today, and a huge thank you to you, Olive. And I will be back with another video again soon, and I'll have the links for where you can connect with Olive below this video. So take care, everyone, and I look forward to seeing everybody soon. Thanks, Olive.